Hello everyone, and welcome to this cool challenge in which I see how far I can get in 1 hour in Splatoon 2. So let's go. So we start off by going into the first level and doing pretty well, getting some good time saves and getting the first sapfish. Second level was also pretty easy, although I kind of bumped my head near the end and it hurt a bit, but it's okay because I managed to get the next sapfish. The third level and 10 minutes in included a lot of these spinning ink machines or something like that that keep trying to kill me, but they failed, and so did I when I later on tried the parkour and lost some time there, but also got the zapfish nevertheless, and headed on to the boss day. I fought him and dodged some bread, and saved time by intentionally getting hit. I climbed his tentacle and got the first boss zapfish. I got on to the next area with 15 minutes on the clock, and went head first into an Octo Turf War. Not much happened, and I completed the stage. The next level had a lot of ink furlers, and were tricky at times when there were loads of Octarians shooting left, right, and centre at me. Near the end, you got to use an ink cannon to finish the level. Stage 4 gave me an ink roller, and at 20 minutes, I needed something fast, and it didn't disappoint, flinging ink everywhere and paving a clear path to the end. The hero dualies in the next one were not only fast but also fun. Dodging around ink reels, collecting eggs, and killing things got us a win, and free ticket to the next stage, in which was a harder one. With the ink charger given to us, it cost us some time with aiming and how you had to go on a mission to get keys, and a whole lot more patience. This one was not a quick level, but we got there in the end eventually. Not much happened in level 7, but it brought us on to the boss stage, which we made quick work of by going up to him early and knocking him back when he was just about to attack. Even at phase 3, I still made quick work of him and got the next boss sapfish. Moving on to Becker's Depot and going in with the Slosher, the next stage was very bizarre, with Octo Seekers scouting out the area. I even got to the top of one to get the zapfish. The next stage saw the return of the Octo Turf War, and, among other things, 8 mini zapfish, which were quickly added to my collection, and went on to a fun level with tons of bouncy pads and so many salmon eggs. This level was like a nice little break after going through all the other levels. Quite the opposite of the next level, which gave me the Splatling to complete the level. And with me having to avoid Octo Snipers, it consumed a lot of my time and took me to 50 minutes in. The next stage was just annoying. Not too much to say about it, but all I did was try and catch these little running things. It took me a while because they were just so slippery. Stage 14 was long but fun. It entailed running as an Octo Sniper tries to shoot you, but at the end you get to 180 him and get that zapfish. With only 5 minutes left on the clock, I had to kill at least one more boss, and so I gave it a really good go, but jumping, swimming and shooting this big cube with legs and getting the tentacle on top wasn't too easy. There was a lot of tight spots I got out of there, but it was worth it when I got to the fish and the timer stopped. If you think you can do better, which you probably can, make sure to tell me in the comments how far you got. This video was quite short and different, but if you liked it, really make sure to let me know so I can do more. But until then, I do hope you've enjoyed, and goodbye.